Good afternoon for the diehards who are still here. This session is also about angle brackets, so if you don't want to see it, you better hide. I'm going to tell you about the real-life implementation on versioning within the XBRL project. We have just created our first production versioning report, and what the interesting aspects were that I stumbled across by implementing it. Oh, this one. Okay. What is this? To set some ground, you have to envision how the SBR-Netherlands project works. We have a multi-entry point DTS, which is for versioning very important because you need versioning reports per entry point. A versioning report is not a technical report, because that would then there would be no necessity to put it in by entry point. If it's just a technical resume, a kind of diffing, if you like, from a taxonomy, then there would be no use for an entry point specification. The DTS authors of the SBR are really independent. We have written architecture for SBR Netherlands that they have to keep. So tuples in, dimensions in, type dimensions in or out. There are rules about that, like any other taxonomy building, but in essentially, within those rules, they are free how they are going to create their DTS. There's one part of the SBR Netherlands taxonomy that is not free for them. That's the part that is with shared common concepts. That's is about shared financial concepts and shared non-financial concepts like name, address, blah, 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 things like that. These are centralized, and the versioning report for this centralized part of the DTS has been given to the domain partners only. So there's a phasing in creating the versioning reports, because the first phase of creating the core taxonomy, as you will, is only for domain partners and has only a very limited number of recipients, about four. User group that we are aiming for with this first phase is the DTS authors and the DTS extenders who are creating another DTS, not the extenders that you would normally think in US ECC terminology. We are not aiming at extensions for reports. It's not allowed at this moment in the Netherlands. We are aiming for software developers with the phase two versioning. So the DTS domain partners, the ones that create that part of the DTS, are aiming with their versioning award for software developers to help them create an automated mapping process. Accountants are off. That would be completely different than the story that Haiko is going to tell you. This first phase, it contains on tuples, items, domains, domain members, no real dimension, no hypercubes, because we are talking a core DTS here. There's no presentation involved. There's no validation on this. You can enter this in your DTS, you can enter that. The core DTS is just providing you with a setup of building blocks of, you can use this address, you can use this financial concept. If you want to use it as a domain partner, that's up to you. It's not for the SBR project itself. This is the list of the stuff that we are concerned with in versioning for the first phase. So no presentation, calculation, definition links. The definition link is not completely true because we have a domain-domain member relationship, but that's all. Generic labels. We have labels on every XML node. So if you have an enumeration, normally there's no real way to attach a label to that. But you can put an ID on it, and with an ID, there's an option of creating a generic label. So every node in the SBR taxonomy has a label, and you need to version that. And as you will see later on, it gets interesting in how you're creating those IDs. The second phase, like I said, is for the SBR domain partners to create the DTSs. Those can handle deep dimensions. This year will be the first year that part of them will be using dimensions. So they will have presentation and definition links. And also, they are compliant to have generic labels on every XML node. What's this? Okay. A couple of weeks back, we finalized the first phase. First of May is always the important date of the SBR project that the core taxonomy has to be ready. And then there's 2 weeks of evaluation by the domain partners. That means that in those 2 weeks, you can have comments that would change the alpha version. And now the first challenge will be coming up. Are you going to versionize the versioning report? Or are you going to be versioning on the first old version to the next renewed version? I don't know. We chose for only one versioning report. So there is no versioning on the errors that are reported within those 2 weeks time. I can imagine that people who are implementing the DTS and have implemented the alpha version are really confused now that they get a new versioning report and everything has been changed because there were reports that things were wrong, etc. So you need to have a process to support the way you're supplying your versioning report. The consumption part of the versioning for phase one, we don't have any experiences with it yet. The versioning report has been delivered to the domain partners, and as I said, they are pretty self-supporting, so they can do whatever they like with it. If they have automated processes in creating their own upgrade for their part of the DTS that they are creating, or that they are doing it manually, no feedback yet, unfortunately. This is how we made the versioning report for the first phase. You probably heard of the application RL, made by one of our esteemed friends in this room. In technical sense, it's diffing two taxonomies, and you could do that with IFRS to USSEC, but it wouldn't give much common ground. But if you have two versions of the same taxonomy, it finds a lot of the same concepts that are there. The merge, split, and rename actions that you need to identify within the versioning report, because RL will only give you, because it's a diffing tool, the adds and deletes. So you need to group those into merging and splitting events and possibly renaming events. We have created our own tooling for that purpose. It's the input is the versioning report as is, with only adds and deletes, and then the our own tooling is enabling you to group these kinds of events together and state, no, this is not an add and delete, this is a rename. Also, you need to think about grouping the actions. If you have actions dedicated by the way you're working by concept, because you could work concept by concept through your taxonomy. Every concept change, close the action, go to the new concept, make the changes that are there, change the labels or the order in the presentation or whatever, and go there concept by concept. Another way of looking at it, you could say, no, I have one event. First, I'm going to do all the presentation stuff, then I can do all the labels, and then etc. You need to think about how your public that is consuming this versioning report will react to it. What do they need? For this core taxonomy, we've chosen to go by event, and only the special events like merging and splitting, they need to be grouped together. So these have special actions, but all the rest is grouped by technical event. For software mappers, I can imagine that the choice will be that it's done by concept. You have to remember that the events will be judged by the software developer whether they have impact or not. If they see that there is a special event for changing the balance attribute and they don't do anything with the balance attribute, they can program something in there that says, if I see this event, just toss it. Unfortunately, we had to manually append the generic labels to these actions. There's just no other way. You need to have real software, integrated versioning, recreating the taxonomy. This, the story that Katrine told you, it's a real process. It should be interlocked with one another. You start with why I'm going to change something, then do the change, close the change, go to the next one. That requires specific software, and we just don't have it. Fortunately, the core taxonomy is not thousands of concepts, so you probably remember which ones you've changed and why you made the change. I'm going to show you what it is actually looking like. This is a screen from RL showing you the versioning report on the upper right hand, and you can see that there's the namespace renaming, which is the basis of any versioning report, because there's two versions of one taxonomy, then you need to have a different prefix, otherwise the whole system gets screwed. The assignments, we chose to have a generic business assignment and a generic technical assignment. I'm sorry that the labels are in Dutch, but that's the way we're looking at it, and we're not English. So. We're chose for these two generic kind of assignments and explain all the actions in the action labels itself and not in the assignments. You could, the version and specification would allow you, explain the setup that you made in the assignments and have a one-to-one relationship with actions. It's up to you. Then you can see that that they're organized by event, because there's all concept add events in the first action and all concept label adds in the second, etc. This is how our versioning report for the core taxonomy for the non-financial stuff looks like. And if you look to the angle brackets, then you see, because maybe you can't see this in the back, that there are much more from and to DTSs than that there were in the namespace renames. There's, in my view, a glitch in the specification of versioning that states that if you add a new schema to the setup that you want to communicate, not the really DTS, because if it's discovered by an importer or link-based ref, then there is only one schema ref necessary. But if it's a separate entry point and it's a completely new schema, there's no event that says there's a new schema. So then to solve that, we put in all the two DTS schemas and all the from DTS, because there's this double schema was being removed. You don't see it in the two. And you see here in the two that there are all kind of ISO and UNCFACT schemas being added, which are not present in the from. So you have to deduct, either by interpretation or by software, that these are new schemas and deleted schemas. There's no other way of communicating this. Well, this is our way. There's no presentation kind of thing for accountants, so there's no PDF, there's no HTML, etc., because this goes to techies. This goes to the domain partners who are implementing their own DTS. They know software, so there's no real need to make a fancy layout, which is completely different for my neighbor who will do the rest of this presentation.
Haiko Philip. I'm from the IFRS Foundation. I'm a project manager dealing on the IT part in the IFRS taxonomy team at the foundation. The basic scenario we are looking at from the IFRS perspective is that we're providing an IFRS taxonomy where we don't know all our stakeholders. So the stakeholders of the IFRS taxonomies are regulators around the world, and we think that we have to somehow communicate changes between one IFRS taxonomy version and the other one, because our the projects are depending on our taxonomy might very well need that kind of information in an automated fashion, which then they could incorporate into their processes when updating or when dealing with updated dates from the IFRS taxonomy. So that's why we see the versioning report as a kind of educational material. We see that the versioning report provides technical information, but also we see that there is furthermore required a kind of human-readable version. We have published a versioning report in our last final release, which was a couple of months ago, where we provided the changes from the IFRS taxonomy 2010 to IFRS taxonomy 2011. And in this a release package, you will find also a versioning report as specified by the XII working group, as well as an HTML version, a rendering kind of solution to show differences between these two taxonomies on an HTML base. The whole production of this material is an internal process, internal development based on internal tools. So why is that? First, because we were having a look at the versioning issue for quite some time and are working with the XII versioning working group and providing them feedback. So internal development was much more useful first, because when we started a couple of years ago in this area, there were no really tools supporting versioning because there was no spec in the beginning. And it is much more flexible for us. We have full control, and as I said, it provides good feedback to the spec group, and if something is wrong, then we can change it very easily in our internal process and don't have kind of delay in terms of implementation. So the versioning working versioning report we're providing on our website supports the following versioning modules as defined by the working group. It's the versioning base, the versioning concept base basic, the versioning concept extended, and the versioning relationship module. So I assume you are familiar to these modules introduced by Katrin Schmid also in an earlier presentation. Right now, we don't support the dimensional modules, so this is something which we could still improve in our internal process, and as soon as we have some more resources available to do that, we will work on that. So don't see the whole stuff as a final product. It's still a development in terms of process perspective. Also right now, what is not so good in my perspective is that we are losing on the way in the production of the versioning report in our internal process somehow the reason why we did that change. So this is something which we could further improve in the whole process, but I will tell you a little bit more about that in the following slides. So the HTML report is something very important which comes out of that process. Its production is fully based on the versioning report. It's a comprehensive overview covering different perspectives. And as said, we see it as an educational material where you can see very clearly what has been changed in a particular link base, which gives you further insight of content changes in the taxonomy. But also we provide a different perspective where we just list edits and deleted concepts for technical people who are interested in that. Okay, here's our process. We have When we're dealing with the taxonomy development, we are having external feedback coming from our external stakeholders, and we have internal feedback where we have discussion with our board members, and we collect all these feedbacks in an Excel spreadsheet. This is done by an accountant who is not so much interested in the whole XBRL thing, so we rather keep it simple, just an Excel spreadsheet. Please add an element at this position in the link base, and then I'm reading that change, and then I'm implementing that into XBRL in the taxonomy. So of course this Excel spreadsheet plus the old taxonomy will be then through labor work transformed into a new IFRS taxonomy, and then we are creating the versioning report and the HTML rendering afterwards, after that process. Kind of issues we are facing right now in this process is that somewhere here we're not capturing the reason in this Excel spreadsheet, which then kind of is also the issue, so that information couldn't reach further down the process chain to the actual end report here at the very end. So yeah, we could add that information here in the future, and then there is an additional kind of issue with that. You might have then the reason in the Excel spreadsheet, but once you implemented that change in the taxonomy, you have to identify the change coming from that Excel spreadsheet and the specific cell to the actual implementation, the diffing which comes out when diffing these two taxonomies, and that might not always be easy. So the first option we have at the foundation is that we improve further this process, this in-house development, or we are going a totally different way, that we have a look at the software market and see if software maybe can provide that kind of linkage. It would pretty much ease our world, because we don't have to deal anymore. The software is providing quality assurance, and we're right now in the position where we haven't been 2 years ago, where software is available to cover the whole thing. So that is definitely an option. Yeah. So downside would be, of course, that if we are going the way with software, we cannot provide that much feedback anymore to the working group, because we are losing kind of the control over the whole thing. And also a downside would be if the spec is changing, we cannot easily adapt our process anymore, and we have to wait for an update of the software in order to be then compliant again with the new version of the working group. So this is something we have to think about a little bit more. Yeah, problem with the in-house development is that you need to know the spec very well, that you need a software developer in your team, that it requires a lot of time. And so, yeah, you have to always trade off these two things. What is kind of essential is that we are very committed to provide the versioning solution in future taxonomy releases, and we're definitely supporting the versioning solution as a kind of standardized way to communicate that to our stakeholders. So I'm going to show you right now what we're providing in terms of HTML rendering, and this is giving you a kind of perspective. I hope you can see it. See if I can make it bigger. So this rendering provides you kind of the overall global context, and everything which has a green background is, for example, added as a link base. So that means we have added in the 2011 taxonomy a new ELR named that way, and we have added these concepts in this structural hierarchy in this particular link base. And then you can see that some of the lines are underlined. These are completely new concepts. You see the reference, you see the kind of type. What type is that? Is it a text block? Is it a table? Is it an axis? Is it maybe a default member? And so it's not just purely a presentation view. it combines a lot of information from all the link bases available in the taxonomy. So this information, if it's a default member from the dimension mentioned here on the level above, is derived from the definition link base. So it's not just purely print of the presentation link base, it's a combined view where also additional information flows in from the calculation link base. You can see very, very easy that not underlying concepts were existing in the old taxonomy. So these three are new, these were existing, but also within existing concepts we have maybe changed something, which is, for example, added a reference, which is then indicated by an underlined reference. We have maybe deleted a reference, which is indicated through a strike through. And that also gives us from not just to our stakeholder a very good overview of what's going on in the taxonomy and its content, but also provides us with a kind of quality assurance when we're having a look after the whole changes are implemented into taxonomy. We can very easily go through that HTML and see if something did go wrong during the implementation phase. For example, if we have missed certain things which we thought must have been added to the taxonomy, we can easily spot that and go through that and don't have to all the time have a look from the taxonomy from a scratch. We can just focus on the changes, which is kind of nice thing if you think in a quality assurance perspective. So yeah, that is something I would like to see in software tools, because right now tools can consume versioning reports. Maybe they can process it on the machine basis, but it's machine readability is important, but it's also very important that you kind of prepare that information to the users sitting in front of the computer to see what's going on. So this is just one example. If you have other ideas, it's totally valid as well. And so yeah, that's how we think that the versioning report can be used and how it can be utilized in our processes in the overall. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, let me know.
Questions,
if I may. I got a surprise package for you. If you're really interested in experimenting with dimensions, you can leave your business card here, and I'll get you a 20-page manual on how to create a versioning report with 50 use cases that's handling every event in detail, so you can experiment it with yourself, and hopefully we'll get versioning flying.
Yep.